love the new season's crop, but come autumn, there's always a glut of fruit and vegetables. One of my favourite ways to preserve them is to make a delicious chutney.
So I've got a lot of tomatoes here, and you know when they get a bit overripe, perfect for chutney.
First, blanch, skin and chop 900 grams of tomatoes.
Put that in the pan first because that adds the moisture.
Then I'm adding three peppers, three medium onions, a courgette, an aubergine and four cloves of garlic. But you can add any vegetable you like as long as its weight comes up to around 2.5 kilos.
Now to the ginger. When I was making chutney in my younger days, there was not such a thing as fresh ginger. There was ginger, you bought it from the greengrocer, but it was all shriveled and dried. But how much nicer now we have fresh ginger. I use it a lot in recipes and I love it. Might have to scrape it down. That's it. Looking around, what else have I got to add? It's the chilli. Now, you make it as hot as you want to. I'm adding one fair-sized chilli. All the veggies are in there, and I'm just starting it on a low heat.
You'll need to leave this simmering for about an hour. Just give it an occasional stir.
Should be ready. Gosh, look at that, wonderful colours coming through. It's beginning to look like chutney.
Now it's time to add the spices and seasonings that make it special. 1 tablespoon of paprika, 1 tablespoon of salt,
and then some pepper, just to your liking. And then I'm going to do some crushed mustard seed. It'll make it really piquant. So in that goes.
Then add 300 ml of distilled malt vinegar and 350 grams of granulated sugar.
Right, all the ingredients are in there. Give it a good stir. Now that smells a bit like a pickle factory. I love it because it reminds me that I'm going to get a wonderful chutney in the end.
Once the sugar has dissolved, turn up the heat and bring it to the boil. While it's reducing, take care it doesn't catch on the bottom of the pan.
Right, it's got to the right consistency. There is no runny liquid in the bottom. So I'm going to turn the heat off. That looks really good. You see, that is chutney consistency. So here I've got a selection of sterilised jars. Just dollop that in. That's it. Push the chutney down. Make sure you don't have any air bubbles in it. Chutney will keep 2 years, providing you've got a good seal on the top. And once open, keep it in the fridge. I put it in the fridge because then it's always to hand and we eat a lot of chutney.
Special things about the Tangmere allotment is that it's not only about growing.
What I like is that you have cooking sessions here. Yeah. You know, you make pizzas, you've got a sort of a cooker over there.
Sort of a cooker? How rude is that? It's not a range cooker, it's a washing machine drum from the local tip. Yeah. And we build a fire in the middle, we've got a great big pan, and off we go.
All these vegetables gleaned from around me. We've got butternut squash, I can see some swede, the leaf of the chard, is that right, is in there?
Yes, it is.
And there's courgettes, tomatoes, and are you putting a sauce on there?
Yep, this is just Greek yogurt and eggs with some seasoning. So we're just going to put that on the top there.
Do we put cheese on that as well?
Yes, we can do. We've got some grated cheese.
That's a good covering. And then into the oven until...
Until it's set.
Set and a gorgeous golden brown. I can't wait for that.
It is so satisfying to turn your vegetables into something delicious.
Ooh, look at that!
And my next recipe is a wonderful way to make the most of them.
The popular lamb shanks are the rather large ones that come from the hind leg of a lamb. And they're very big. These are the foreshanks. That's from the front leg of the animal. And I think these are a much better size for one portion. And if you cook them long and slow, they taste absolutely delicious.
First, brown the shanks in some really hot oil.
The reason for browning them is it sears the outside. Also, it gets a lovely brown crust on them, and that helps to give colour to the casserole at the end, as well as flavour.
Now add two large sliced onions and two cloves of garlic.
Give that a good stir around.
Once these have softened, add 400 ml of beef stock.
So bring that to the boil.
To thicken the gravy, take a rounded tablespoonful of flour and add 300 ml of red wine.
And just mix that to a paste. And because it's cold, it won't go in lumpy. So I'll pour that in, stirring all the time, and that will just thicken it up a little.
To give the gravy extra depth, I like to add a teaspoon of chopped rosemary and a tablespoon of red currant jelly.
It looks pretty delicious there, and I'm just going to let it cook slowly now at 140 fan for about 2 hours, just until it's tender. I like to boil them for about 8 to 10 minutes in salted water, so they're just tender. And then half of them I just toss into butter. Oh, you've got to be strong to carry this lot. Oh, look at that. It's a really good, rich brown colour.
Now add the rest of the vegetables to the casserole.
So everybody will have some vegetables that are actually in the casserole and some that are lovely and fresh looking and colourful. And then a little of the sauce over the top. So isn't that something really, really special? Now, I can't resist having a taste. It's coming away like a dream. Look at that. Don't you wish you were me? Do you know what? That's a cracking recipe. Do I push it right to the back?
Yep.
That's it.
There we are. Hey. This is what it's all about. A day on the allotment, producing wonderful food, and the reward right at the end of the day is a great gathering like this. Tables being laid, all the food has come off the land. So I'm going to join them, and I'm hoping there's a very nice glass of cold white wine as well. Here's to Tangmere Community Garden, every success in 2015.
Thank you. Cheers.